The race for the 2023 PBR World Title heats up as the season approaches the midway point.
Kaiki can do no wrong at the moment. 93 points. Andrew Alvidrez in back-to-back weeks. Different year, same Leme.
The best bulls on the planet continue to cast big moments on the dirt.
Oh! It almost defies the laws of nature.
While four cowboys have emerged as the early front runners,
our world number one flashes his badge.
Today, the fight continues, where one single ride can change an entire season in the blink of an eye.
He takes a shot.
The PBR rides into Sacramento.
Take all the home field advantage he could get with the crowd. Sky Harbor's bucked off 31 straight. Make that 32. Clock's going to stop here in 2 and 43, and it seems the playbook is ever changing on Sky Harbor, but no one can seem to find the solution.
Yeah, the result's always the same, and he's kind of a head scratcher, but he gets guys setting down flat. And that anytime you miss a bull of this caliber front end, you're gonna pay the price and hit the ground. This bull, there's no set pattern.
To the side, but he had the rope. Campbell converts, conquers Cold Creek. The first two, well, that went the bovine athlete's way. This one is Campbell all day.
Well, and, you know, we talked about it. He's feeling good. Talked about it before the ride, the effort that Boudreaux puts out each and every time, and I really feel like that's his best attribute. Like, technically, he might mess some things up here or there, but he never lacks for effort. And this bull puts a lot of guys on the ground. He's really strong. He's got a lot of forward movement. Boudreaux is just not willing to give up.
85 points for Campbell. Off to the side for the last second. Docked the score a bit from the judges, but nevertheless, Campbell is now the standard here in Sacramento as the lone score on the board. Came here in Sacramento 2 years ago. Taylor, though, gets forward and takes a hit on the way out. Homebrew proves too much for Taylor on this occasion. T quickly makes his way back towards Sports Met.
Yeah, it looks like he took a shot there coming down and starts him really good. Homebrew's just right up under himself, gets him top heavy, and maybe hits him on the way down. Really close to stepping all over him. Bullfighter's just doing a great job. That triangle converging.
Yeah, and we've heard from Cody Webster, one of three bullfighters that is out there this weekend.
It's like, that's all you need. Here we go.
And it seemed, of course, everything was going Silvano Alves' way. We all saw the contact. You could feel it and hear it here inside Golden One Center. And Justin just brings us directly to how humbling the sport is. It seemed everything was going so perfect for Silvano until that contact.
Yeah, and in the blink of an eye, it can all go wrong. And sports medicine out there right away, tending to him. And
all of the riders looking on as well. Let's bring you back to what just happened here in just a matter of about 7 seconds.
Well, he's making a great ride. Pookie Holler is having a really tough day here, good day. And just goes forward and you see the shot right there.
Sports medicine is taking all the time they need inside the arena as they do evaluate Silvano Alves there on the dirt. You did just hear Golden One Center cheering as well. You're seeing why they're called the toughest athletes on dirt. Injuries so real in this sport, but you see there the three-time champ giving a thumbs up to the crowd here inside Golden One Center. We'll keep you updated on Alves's condition the best we can. But out of position quickly here. Makes his way to his feet. July does it yet again. Moves that perfect record to 18-0. So that yet, well, that's just going to have to wait.
That's going to have to keep waiting, isn't it? And this is just such a good little bull. I mean, there's no tricks. There's nothing phony right here. He just turns out of there kicking and spinning. Here comes the fastball. Can you keep up?
2-49 is when DeCastro goes flying. As for July, 44 3/4, very similar to Alakazam's out.
And you know, Kate, right here we are. This is going to be a dogfight.
Now Petrie's on the clock. There's the nod. Wow. Sent flying through the air. Another all-star out for Alakazam. That's what he's done all season. He's perfect.
Yeah, he's been really good all year. And look, he just beats Petrie out of the chute right here. Like, he is beat from word go. That's all Alakazam. Head picked up. He's seeing where he's going to hit because he's got no shot of getting around the corner.
That clock stops the moment the rider's hand is not making contact with his rope. And, well, that happens here for Petrie in 1-71. Ready, DeBrito. There's the nod. He's ready, too. Wow. We said it's bovine superstars. They heard and wanted to prove their point here on the West Coast. Another huge out. Snake Eyes gets DeBrito down in 1-21.
Yeah, and that's a good score that he puts up. Like, it's a little bit like we've seen with Alakazam just beating his guy out of the chute. I mean, DeBrito was, he nodded, but I don't think he was really ready.
88 1/4 was that score. Let's see what he could do here. Salgado sent flying to the rafters inside Golden One Center aboard Smooth Steel. Another rider to the dirt too early. Clock stops here in 5-09.
And he's got it locked down going left. I mean, he's got Smooth Steel all day long going left. But when this bull jumps out of it, you got to go with him. You can't keep riding left. You have got to. Plans change in bull riding. You know, the bull, every jump can change it up, and you've got to go with them.
Salgado's wishing someone would have hit the lights.
Yeah, yeah. This bull doesn't level off, and he'll get to stepping ahead a little bit.
He hangs on. Davis does it. He does it again. The world champ goes the distance. It was off to the side of Express Lane, but he made the whistle.
Hey, we've seen two qualified rides now, and both of them were nothing but guts and determination to get the whistle. Cooper Davis here is in bad shape the second jump. This bull has a really big one out of there, and when he turns back, he's got Cooper raised up and at the end of his arm, and he refuses to give up.
We're being told now the judges are going to review this for time, make sure his riding hand was still in contact with his rope at the 8-second mark.
I think his hand's going to be in the rope. It'll be whether or not he touches the ground
that
or something
too.
Like that, because Cooper Davis's hand was not coming out of there.
Well, you heard him say, "I didn't touch him."
Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't think he came close to touching the bull, and I don't think his hand comes out. It'll just be whether or not he had hit the dirt. And he is upside down underneath of him. And it's an 8 there. You know, you couldn't see it.
And he is getting a score.
Now, it's not going to be a big one. But it's going to be good to get a score where there's only one other qualified ride.
And Davis, pumped up as he should be, is standing by with Matt.
Coop, we know that a determined Cooper Davis is a dangerous Cooper Davis. You showed us all just how bad you want this tonight.
Yeah, that was dangerous all the way around and embarrassing at the same time. But, yeah, I mean, I stayed on when it counted and wish it would have been prettier.
Still got a score. Congratulations.
Thank you.
In 22, second in the event. 490s in the city. Can he make it 5? muscle chiseled away from his hand. Direction doesn't matter. Dalton does it again in the 15-15.
That's such a great old bull right there. And that's what you would call a rider-friendly bull, because you watch here when he leaves out of here. He's got Castle stuck. Like, all Castle's weight's running down his left leg. He's trying to get it shifted over, and you just see him lean with his upper body to the right, trying to get it around there, and Chiseled will allow for that.
And he takes a lead, 88 and a quarter for Castle, and he's standing by with Matt.
It's all an 88 and a quarter. You're going to take the lead in this 15-15, but you don't look overly excited right now.
Yeah, no, I didn't ride that bull very well. I ride better than that, and that was pretty piss poor.
Just shows you how bad these guys want to win and be at their very best.
First time Lemmy and Charmer are matching up. There's the nod. Whoa! Lemmy lights out aboard Charmer. Uncanny exit, but he gets to his feet and looks as though he's made the whistle.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll take another look at this because it was pretty close to the 8 seconds, but there's a lot of great stuff that happens in this ride right here. This is a big, strong bull. He gets really steep, drops out of the air. Jose was doing a great job trying to find his front end every time it would come up. And you watch, the second he misses it, this bull turns back to the ride a little bit, flattens out, it sets him down. And then when the kick comes the next time, whoa.
So it is under review, and we're hearing that the clock actually started late, so they'll go back to the nod and when that gate first opens and make sure that clock is starting on time.
If this bull keeps this up and down going like this, I think Jose rides him no problem. It's never even close, but it's when he tries to turn back and he doesn't kick right there. Yeah, it sets him down, and then once the kick starts coming again, a lot of momentum. Ooh, close with the free hand there.
And if there is contact with the free hand, that will be an automatic disqualification.
I don't think he has his rope at 7-9 and change here. He still got it there. See right there, he still got the rope.
Lemmy looking on. We're being told now they're going to look at this in real speed because that clock started late. And trying to put himself in position for a record time 8th bucking battle win. Both Lemmy and Pacheco came in just one win short of Joao Ricardo Vieira. And well, number 8 has to start with making the 8, and then it would be up to the judges on the score. It's not just every second counts here, but every millisecond seems to count for Lemmy.
Yeah, they just got to get it started as he leaves.
If you could give it to him for effort, it would be there all day long. And he's getting a score. Let the crowd show you the love, Lemmy, because once again, one of the greatest we've ever seen gets yet another qualified ride, and now it's up to the judges. Will it be enough?
And he loves being able to try this bull again.
Oh, Alvidrez, unable to make the whistle, is going to come down at 6-25. Takes a couple hits on the way out as well, and you could see it there as he grabs onto the steel.
Dalton, I know you weren't extremely excited about your performance here today, but again, rising to the occasion in a big moment. What is it about these 15-15 bucking battles and these big moments that make you really step up to the challenge?
You know, it helps having a great crowd like Sacramento. I've always enjoyed coming to this place, and these bulls that are better caliber make me aggressive, and that's what I need, is to be aggressive on every bull I get on, and these bulls have been fitting my style, it seems like, of late.
Worked out today. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Thank you, Matt. And we're going to make this official.
Ready? Let's go, Sacramento!
Ride, 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 ride.
the...
And a crazy start to the night, and there is a ton to unpack here. The great news is Elijah is on his feet, and watch this replay right here as the 28-year-old from Colorado. And here it is, and Matt, this guy just trying his guts out right here to get to 8 seconds, and he's eventually going to pay the price.
Yeah, that's the kind of effort we are expecting from all of these guys. Look at this, bullfighters trying to, by the hair on his chinny chin chin. Ready? Let's go, Sacramento!
And a crazy start to the night, and there is a ton to unpack here. The great news is Elijah is on his feet, and watch this replay right here as the 28-year-old from Colorado. And here it is, and Matt, this guy just trying his guts out right here to get to 8 seconds, and he's eventually going to pay the price.
Yeah, that's the kind of effort we are expecting from all of these guys. Look at this, bullfighters trying to, by the hair on his chinny chin chin.
Young man making his debut on this tour. Let's help him. Whoa, keep going, Tyler. Oh. Keep going. Come on. What a stellar bull ride.
Look at this.
Never panicked, did he?
He acted like he's been here for years, like he belongs. He weathers the storm, gets to the 8 seconds.
And awaiting the numbers to come in. Remember 86?
Yeah, he's waiting for the numbers, but also you see being tended to by our sports medicine team.
Here we go.
Ooh.
Look out, boys. Whoop, whoop.
Welcome back, Cody Webster.
Yeah, this one.
That's a high voltage bull right there.
That's a high voltage bull. He's having a ball, that guy.
That's right. That is. Big time stuff. You see Leonardo. Watch this. This is, it's going to get kind of scary. Watch that left foot kind of gets hung up in that flank on the way through.
And then look at CW.
Yeah, look at the guys.
That's 220, son.
Yeah, he was plugged in. California. Come on. What's up, California?
Wow. Yeah. Loving it. Numbers are in. How about 86 3/4 points?
He left Sacramento as the champ. Let's get it done on Lights Out. Can he do it?
And the answer is yes. De Lima
Rocking and rolling onto a qualified ride. Solid score. How about 85 points? 85. And DeLima.
Every quest. What's right. This is another thing I can't do anywhere else.
I can't wait.
And Cindy Rosser bringing us this bull, California Bull. Adriano Salgado. Oh, yeah, look at LT, Cody Webb.
Nice little cape. Adriano Salgado stepping in here and taking one around to the left. 8 seconds later, he's picking up a TAC qualified ride. Scores coming in for that guy right there. 82 3/4 points. 82 3/4. And Salgado on the board.
Cadburger Bucking Bulls. Here we go. Yeah. Wow. Petrie. Outstanding.
We're going to make a deal with Richard.
Okay.
Next time the bull Reba McEntire bucks,
right,
we're going to find some Reba McEntire rock and roll mix.
There you go.
Well, remember, 89 points is in the lead. The numbers, 89 3/4.
Okay.
Here we go.
Look out, because Cooper Davis looks locked in tonight. And
yeah,
the 2016 world champ, take a look at this. Drops that elbow right back to the middle, no problem, old school cool. 84 3/4 points for Cooper Davis.
All right.
84 3/4 puts him fifth in the round. This is Jose Vitor Leme. Here we go. He is so good. He is so, so talented. And you watch back at the beginning of this ride, you can see the clock says 8 seconds.
Oh.
But our officials.
Some drama. Some drama here. Now we're going to go back and look at this, make sure the I's are dotted and the T's are crossed, Matt.
They're looking at that right hand. That right hand that is up in the air, they're looking to see if at any point before the 8 seconds, that right hand makes contact with the bull himself or the ground. And I think they're going to be looking to see if he touches the bull. A replay official looking at
I think this is a waste of our time.
I couldn't agree more.
Well,
how many of you think he made it? Well, Jose Vitor Leme anxiously awaiting the view of that right there. And you are absolutely right. He made it.
Looking for 90. Good stuff.
Mauricio. two in a row.
Yep. So as we await the scores coming in, you watch the CDCR replay tonight. 86 and a half points, 86 and a half are the numbers. So a quick question, JRV. Let's ride. You're not going to phase JRV this week, I'll tell you that. Tough start, and you see flags on the ground. There is going to be a re-ride opportunity because of the way that that ride started. The bull hipped himself on the bucket chute. So they are going to give him the option for another one. So 77 and a half. And the way he said, yeah, I'm going to take one. I'm going to take it.
So JRV going to get on another one. That'll work. It's capable of striking a 90-plus point bull ride at any time. Here we go. Oh, no! He got rocked. And I do not like that. Where he is holding. Watch this. Watch this CDCR replay. Oh! And now you got to worry about that collarbone right there where he got hit.
Our PBR sports medicine team right there with Kyler Oliver, and that's a guy that just, it's just been injury after injury after injury. Just when we think we got him back, anymore.
Speaking of Yellowstone, we've been through this before. Get him. Get him. Uh-huh. Oh, my God. It's Rip. Roping bull.
It is.
That's him.
It actually is.
Look at him. Yeah. That. Are you single again? Are you back to being single now?
He's good. Single.
Okay.
There you go.
Is the one underneath the past PBR Rookie of the Year. Let's help out Keyshawn. Come on, Sack, can't hear you. There you go. He was needing that ride right there. As you watch it back on the replay, the judges are going to go to work. 83 points for Whitehorse, 83. And right now, that'll put him into the top nine for Keyshawn, 83. So there's Keyshawn heading back to the locker room. Gonna be moving up, move him on to Championship Sunday with that 83. There is a look at the Redwood leaderboard. Another ride, another great stop that got him here. Hailstorm is the name of the bull, Julio Moreno. And he hit the eject button.
He went for a, got launched out of there.
Oh, score, Dawson Brandt.
Wow. Tough one. Down and out. Oh, yeah. Tough to ride. Here we go. DK. Let's get him. Let's get him. Oh.
I was going to say, if there was anybody I was going to bet on this bull, it would be Derek Kobach.
And I don't like that, Derek. Here's the replay. The CDCR replay, Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation replay. And Derek and our PBR sports medicine team going to give him a handout. And, oh, man, hope that's superficial, no doubt. But... And thank you, fans, for being supportive there as Derek in obvious pain.
sliding up. Now he's ready to go. Oh, that ball just keeps dropping him. Down.
That got ugly.
Knocks his helmet off. Man, Alito De Souza Jr. feeling the pain here.
Yeah.
Sack.
And, I mean, he's frustrated and rightfully so. He's in a situation right now where, I mean, he doesn't get the train or rolling down the tracks. Great job by our U.S. Border Patrol safety team bullfighters right there. 27th in the world. Got to get to moving.
Flying in from somewhere over Montana. And that Montana silversmith buckle being delivered straight to Shoto and Flint Rasmussen's house right there.
Well, here we go. Well, that's just how he drew it up. Salgado gets it done aboard Callie's Dream, and just like that, we've got a rider two for two.
Hey, and this is a really good job, too, for Adriano. This is one of the better rides I've ever seen him make going away from his hand. That being said, him a left-handed guy, this bull starting to the right. Watch it back on the Can-Am cam, and looked like he touched him right out of there, that first big jump out of there. Looked like his arm might have touched him. I don't think the judges are seeing it, but so good for Adriano. But this is a really good job for him right here.
His best so far this season was a 16th place overall in Manchester. He's now number one here in Sacramento. So Salgado poised to have a personal best. Wyatt Rogers now gets a chance to not only have a good day, but a great one. He could take the overall lead. But when you're paired up against the Punisher, that's usually the way it goes.
Yeah, and I think the Punisher is one of those bulls where he's as much a mental challenge for guys as he is a physical challenge. Like, he's really tough. He's going to give you some weird jumps, some weird timing. And mentally, the guys know he's really mean. He's hard to get by. So you have really got to get yourself in the right frame of mind before you ever attempt him. Steps on him right in the chest.
Tyler Manor is the real deal. Not only can he take the shots, but he can dish it out. He's going to move into the number one position overall. He only needed 77 points, and he's going to get a lot more.
Hey, this kid's got some guts, too, because not only off the highlight that we've seen him getting stomped, but coming back, this is not perfect leaving out of the chute right here. A lot of guys quit right there because they think bad things are about to happen. This guy just bears down, fixes it, and makes a great ride.
Well, it was Manor that brought the bad things against Back Jack, and he is our new number one. Let's send it back down to Kate.
What a weekend you're having. Take us through your reaction of coming into a crowd like this and being able to knock a couple down.
I just knew that I had to stay calm, just take it as any other deal, and just ride my bulls.
You're heading to your first championship round. Has that hit you yet?
Not yet.
Good luck coming up.
Thank you.
Craig.
There it is. You know what that, I feel like
that's
that was,
a good
Mac?
Score.
Right, it's going to be a really good score, but as you mentioned, might not make the 91 and a half that he needs to lead, but that's like hitting the chip shot perfectly on the green to give yourself a chance to make the eagle putt. He came close though, yeah. 89 and a half.
Yeah, this bull stays hooked up, trying. This is a really good ride.
And it's just interesting, right? We're going to have a lot of the show to talk about it, but you've got 18-year-old Tyler Manor in the number one spot in his first ever event and slotted right behind him, the guy that has probably more experience than almost all these guys combined, Jose Vitor Leme. This is one of Julio's playpens. Oh! Finally swung wide. Aaron unable to add to his 86 and three quarters from round number one, but he does have a chance to come back off the strength of that ride aboard Wasted Nights.
And this one, big jump right out of here. It's all there, sucks her back. Both feet come up behind Aaron. He does a good job here. His hands turned over in that bull rope, trying to stay on his feet, giving the bullfighters a shot. And comes out of it, none the worse for wear.
Straight off the set of Wyatt Earp. I mean, that is, yeah. Aaron's got the look for this sport. That is for sure. So Flavio knows he's got a great opportunity. And it's Flavio who gets to sing the winning tune as the hammer feels some pressure from the Brazilian.
And the hammer's got to be thinking, what the heck, man? I go to the left in the first round. Petri rides him. So he says, oh, I'll change it up right here. Big one in a round to the right.
89.
Flavio just sticks it all over, and this is a really good ride.
Well, I think what the guys on the shoots have seen is that if you are paired up against Reba McEntire's the hammer, you're possibly going to be a very happy cowboy. What's the most important thing for a rider to handle that? Well, here we go. I'm going to answer my own question. Just do what Eduardo did.
Do that right there. Whoa!
Oh, gosh! Well, don't do the getaway part. 86 and a quarter, and he looks okay.
These fans are like, what just happened?
Well, they wanted a party. They just got one.
Yeah.
That's the kind of party favor, though, that you remember for a while.
Perfect riding right here. Can't ride him any better. And then he just doesn't take the haze.
Time and a half went for the payback. Not happy he was ridden, and he gets able to exact some revenge, but good to see Eduardo in a joking mood as his one score moves him into the top 10.
That was wild.
Yeah. He gets down to zero. It's an automatic DQ, excuse me. Oh, yeah, I was going to say, you took the word right out of my mouth. That is not, at the moment, it seems, one of DNH's best. Hail Mary might have to throw a Hail Mary of his own.
Yeah, and I think this one was just too hot. You know, no different than a rider that gets too amped up. This bull just gets too amped up, and he's ready to go, and he's really mean. Goes down in the back end right there.
Originally, this has been called a buck off. Gosh, but look at the bullfighters down there.
They're doing everything.
Incredible work. Lucas, Bo, Cody.
Yeah, so this bull right here, he's going down. Now, the rule has been explained to me, if they hit their hawk, that's a re-ride option. That bull hit his hawk. Sounds like he's getting that re-ride.
And he's going to face Cold Chill. He just announced it to the world live on CBS Sports Network. That was kind of cool. Salgado goes the distance, the full eight, and is able to best Empty Glass.
And a good ride here from Tiago. This bull's going to hang his horn and turn out backwards. Tiago doesn't panic at all, doesn't do anything crazy with his free arm, just waits it out, picks up the bull's timing. Just really good control. And you watch his head the whole time. His chin stays down. Even when the bull changed directions and snapped his head up, he gets it right back down. He finds the bull again.
We're still waiting on a score, but starts away and then turns into his hand. Salgado, and I love that you highlighted the patience factor, Mac, because you could almost see the patience developing through the ride. He's still waiting on the score as well. I mean, at the 86 and three quarters is what he will be rewarded with, which moves him in a tie for eighth overall. You were right. Good matchup, not a great dismount, but for Manuelito, that was one that he's gonna like.
Look, this is a really good job by Manny here. I feel like his Achilles heel at times is he rides past the middle. So like these bulls into his hand, he goes past the center on him and gets himself in trouble. He almost did that there, then corrected it, finished his ride.
88 and three quarters. We've now seen a number of great rides in this round, none better in the round than Jose Vitor Leme, but just off the strength of that one score, Manuelito has a legitimate shot at making it into the championship round. Casey Roberts making sure everything's in order. Oh! Hard landing on his back, short circuit. Brought the stuff.
Yeah, and really, really weighted down his right leg leaving out here. You see how all of his weight's running down that side. Oof. He launches it.
I was
right
gonna say, don't try this at home because that's basically like being dropped from a second story balcony and landing on your back.
More like being thrown off of it.
True, true. I don't ever want to be in that situation.
No.
Casey Roberts just was, and he does not seem to be fazed. Denner trying for his first ride this weekend. Barbosa has to like the taste of that one. A soothing 8 seconds aboard Houdini. That definitely shook up Denner.
Yeah, and Denner's a guy, especially for a Brazilian rider, that rides a lot looser on the back of a bull. But you look at his head, a lot like we were talking about with Thiago earlier. His line of sight never leaves that bull's back.
88 and three quarters. That will put Denner in a tie for sixth overall.
Chews him up going left.
And Ramon de Lima, a dominating presence in this round as well. He's now 2 for 2. He's not going to take the overall lead, but in his first event of the season, he's leaving a mark.
Yeah, looks strong, man. Looks strong and comfortable on the back of him. Bulls like this are his bread and butter. This is a bull that we've seen in that first round, as you were talking about. Young Tyler Manor make a really good ride on, and it's kind of this bull's playbook. Like he gets to digging around the corners, moving so much that he gets to missing his front feet a little bit, but a really good bull.
Awarded 87 and a half. That's going to slot him behind Denner Barbosa. That is a second score for Keyshawn and partner. Remember earlier when you said a rider's got to be willing to commit to let his chest come over and hit the back of the bull? That's exactly what we just saw from Keyshawn.
Yeah, look, big effort from Keyshawn right here and that commitment level that you're talking about. And Bubba G, this is a different day for him. This typically isn't what he does. He's usually right there to the left. Here he's out there a couple of rounds to the right. Keyshawn doesn't panic, finishes it, makes a really good ride.
So we have seen a
look
couple
out,
riders. Yeah, look at Flint. Well, maybe when he retires from being our entertainer, he's planning on a boxing career.
No, he better quit boxing guys with helmets on.
Fair enough. That would be a smart career decision on his part, wouldn't it? Guess. Jesse Petrie trying to steal back the spotlight. If it's 87 and a quarter or more, he moves back to the top. and he's got a very realistic shot of being rewarded that. They give him 85 and three quarters.
Yeah, really good ride for Petri, too. And I just love the way this bull's built. Like, he's tall and lanky. Bulls like this have no power. They feel great. He's like an overgrown roping steer right here. Petri just makes a flawless ride.
Well, it wasn't the same type of eight that we saw from Cooper Davis, but it was the same type of mentality from Jesse Petri. Find a way to get to the required distance. Let's send it down to Kate.
Jesse, what a ride. You've been standing on the back of the sheet. You had to wait through everyone for that moment. Patience paid off big. Take us through it.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's kind of just a waiting game, you know, and but it was a really good bull. Felt good to get him rode.
The composure is always here with you, so now to carry that into the championship round, what's the key?
I just keep doing my job and staying on the bulls, you know. When it comes down to it, you got to stay on for 8 seconds, and they'll pay you.
Good luck coming up.
Thank you, man.
Craig.
Classic Cooper. He lands awkwardly and not the way he wanted, but Cooper Davis is headed to the championship round, a place he loves to be.
Hey, that was a fired up, aggressive Cooper Davis right there. That Cooper Davis, look out.
Well, that's the Cooper Davis that we saw at the beginning of the year when he told Kate, I'm only one of four guys that can win this world title. That's that mentality we just saw.
Hey, you look at the aggression, the outside leg with a purpose. You know, he's not just sending it out there hoping, oh, this goes well. He's sending it out there and putting it back down.
Well, his 88 and a quarter points moves him all the way up to fourth overall. He will have a great pick in that championship round draft. The cream always rises to the top on Championship Sunday, and one of these 12 is going to put a cherry on top of his weekend here in Sacramento. We very quickly end the dreams of any rider. And Tiago does a little pirouette with his dismount, not on purpose, as Alakazam continues a great run.
Puts a lot of pressure on his riding hand here. You know, left to right, he's still in really good shape. He's right in the middle of the bull's back. But you can see Tiago, he likes to bring his knees up. He brings them up so high that it sets him down. So left and right, he's good, but he puts way too much pressure on his hand.
This is a very predictable pattern at the beginning of our championship rounds. These are the bulls that are left for the lower riders. They are the ones that automatic DQ. Oh! Barbosa just felt the brunt of what Dennis the Menace can throw at you as the bull runs his record to 21-0.
And that's why I was questioning the pick. Because Dennis the Menace, these are the things he can do. Like, I know in the 15-15 with the lights out that he looked like he was pretty nice to ride, but these big long jumps, and then he is headed uphill and away from you. So as your body comes back, when he starts to go forward, all you can do is come down over this head right here.
And a hit like that will make you rethink.
Look at that thing get up in the air. That bull weighs 1,800.
The athleticism of these bovine athletes, we never can say enough until you see something like that, right? And it illustrates.
Look at that. Oh. Yeah.
We've seen our first qualified ride in the championship round. Manaba tried, or at least thought about trying, a change of direction, but give credit to Flavio. That bull is only allowed until here 3 qualified rides in his career. If it's 88 or better, which it is, 90 and a quarter, we've got a new number one.
Yeah, Manaba really fires out of there. Steep, tried him. This guy's got a lot of fight to him. Really long, lanky arms too, and You know, he's able to give these Bulls a lot. It looks like he's going to be in bad shape, and he's not.
In the first championship round of his young career, he makes it pay off. All the way to the top. Now he gets to watch and wait. Trying to give him some space. Ramon de Lima took away Magic Moves moves. And will he get the 86 and a quarter or more? He's definitely going to do it. My partner thinks so. What do the judges think? Do we have a new number one here in Sacramento? No. 85 and a quarter.
Well, this one was exciting to watch. But as we watch it back, this Bull starts out really good. One, two, three. Goes a little bit long before he finds a spot, and then he jumps out of it. Now he's just jumping and kicking across here. Takes him a little too long to find it again. But, hey, Ramon de Lima, really good weekend.
He has to finish it off. Off to the side yet again, but against Express Lane, he gets a little bit more out of the Bull. It's probably going to be enough to move to the lead. He only needs 85 and three quarters, but you can just see it even through the helmet in Davis's eyes.
Look, I love the effort. Express Lane is a handful. He's always stepping ahead. He's always wanting to race Cooper up the whole time. He fights it. And, you know, he does get him to the outside at the very end, but that's another huge effort from Cooper.
Well, I tell you what, the judges kept him out of the top spot. They award him 85 and a quarter, so he slots in right behind Keyshawn. And that look from Cooper, yeah. I think, kind of said a few things, didn't it?
No, he doesn't agree with
that. Yeah, exactly. And surprise, he's gone with the right stuff. He basically has made his living on the back of this Bull. Well, it's almost a given when Lemmy is on the back of the right stuff that it's going to be a qualified ride. This is one that will change the leader. It just depends how much he gets, because Lemmy knows there's two guys sitting behind him. Jose needs 83 and three quarters to move to the lead. He gets 87 and a half.
Yeah, the right stuff just does not stand a chance against Jose. He knows the feel of this Bull. He knows what to do to ride him. Bull hits the chutes there, takes off again. Doesn't bother Jose one bit.
A Bull score of only 42 and a half. The ROB, rider over Bull, 2.5. That's commonplace for guys like Lemmy. And now he is in a position to win his third event of the season. He's got a career win. It was a couple of years ago in Manchester. Here he goes, Cold Creek. Today was not meant to be career win number two as he goes down at 4.5.
Yeah, and Jesse likes this Bull, I think, more than most guys do. I don't think you would see a lot of guys pick this one that high in the draft. Jumping and kicking out across here. Petri picks his leg up. When the Bull starts right, he's hoping for the left.
What an interesting way to end our time this weekend in the 9-1-6.
Should be around to the left. He will change it up.
But Manor turfs the debut rider, which means Jose Vitor Leme not only has moved to number one in the world this weekend, but he has done it with conviction.
You hear this crowd, they've been behind you all weekend long. Yet another event win. Take us through the start of the season, and it seems you are right on course for that third gold buckle.
Well, it's always special when you get this buckle, but having all these crowns cheering for us, it's for sure different. I feel so happy to another win in my career. Just thank God for another very important points for the world standings. And I just want to keep doing my job and be healthy and ride my bulls.
You mentioned healthy. You had to start the season once again battling through injuries, but now here you are, now the number one rider in the world. What's the key to staying there the rest of the season? Big spot for you.
Well, just keep doing my job, you know. Keep riding my bulls, always put God first in everything, and that's my key, you know. I think everybody wants to be on that spot, so it's not different with me. I'm going to keep working for that, and if God wants, I'm going to stay there.
Congratulations on another win.
Thank you.
Joining us again next Sunday for a full day of bull riding as the Bulls buck into Tulsa. Coverage begins with the championship round on CBS at noon Eastern and continues at 2 p.m. Eastern right here on CBS Sports Network. For Justin McBride, Kate Harrison, Cody Webster, and our entire crew, I'm Craig Hummer. Thanks for watching.
Bull riding's the last gladiator sport.
You get on an animal that can kill you without even trying. It's like trying to control an explosion.
These guys have families, wives, and kids.
It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when they're going to get hurt.